Hello YouTube chess lovers and my friends, this is Gunjan here, and today we are going to discuss about a black opening which has the highest number of opening traps. And the opening we are going to discuss is the Budapest Gambit. Now Budapest Gambit starts like this. So white plays d4, black plays knight f6, and after c4, e5, white take the pawn. And here black has a two genuine reply, knight to g4 and knight to e4. What I have done in this lecture is, first we are going to deal with some of the nice cute short traps where white does not play that much sensibly, and the later stages we are going to discuss where white do play very sensible moves and still fall into some of the nice traps of Budapest. So okay, the first trap we are going to discuss about is in knight g4 line, and where the white plays the queens to d5. Well, moving the queen in early stages, it should not be good, but still, as a black player, you should know how to exploit that. So the correct move is knight c6, attacking on that e pawn. And if your opponent is greedy and maybe he want to try to hang on to that pawn by moves such as f4, then black has a very nice move, which is knight to b5, getting a time on a queen. Well, if you have moved the queen outside, you do not want to put it back again on d1. So most likely the another option for the white is queen to put on e4, where it's controlling the c2 square, where here black has a very good move, which is bishop to c5, now eyeing at f2 square. And here comes the first small cute trap, which is if your opponent is going to play e3, which looks like a defending a pawn, defending that f2 square, but here comes the shock. So bishop takes, and after knight takes, white cannot take that knight, because at the end it will be forked by the other knight. So that is a small cute trap, okay, in the f4 variation. What about at this position, white play a sensible move like knight f3? Well, here black continues with the d6, and now there are two lines. First line, which is very aggressive, which is this one, bishop g5, gaining a time on the queen, so black has to block it. So bishop e7, and now after capture, there's a nice idea. So black captured with the knight, and now it's attacking on the queen. And now most logical square for the queen is to e4, where it's giving a support to the e pawn. Where, and probably he think that, quite think that this pawn is still untakeable, but to his horror, black can capture this pawn. And please note, any moves like h3 or the moves played in the game, for example knight takes, can be met by a wonderful move. I wonder if you can spot it. Yep, it's a queen to d1 check, and after the king takes, knight takes f2, not only black regain the queen, but if you can look at the pawn structure, white has an isolated pawn, and black has a very compact pawn structure, and it will be a very useful asset in the middle game. So that is a one cute trap in queen d5 line. Okay, the another move, which is not immediately bishop g5, but first capturing this pawn. So e cross d6, and now black will play this move, bishop to e6, so gaining time on the queen. Now please note that d cross c7 and queen cross c7 does not help any cause of the white, because the next move will be rook to d8, and black pieces are coming out very very fast. So as a white, you do not want that. So most likely the opponent going to play this move, queen back to base, so queen backs to d1, and now black capture this. And now if he played h3, there is a one nasty trap. If you wish, you can pause the video and you can try to find out. It's a really nice one. The shocking move is knight to f2, and now you can see that queen and a rook is forked, so king has to take this knight. And now comes a beautiful move, which is his check, and this bishop is blocking the king diagonal, which is going back to support the queen, and white will simply lose a queen over here. So that is one of the nasty traps if the opponent plays carelessly, like moves like h3. Okay, so that is some of the lines in queen d5. There are other moves. For example, your opponent can play this move, queen d4, which is somewhat similar to the queen d5 line, but this time white is attacking the knight and defending the pawn. Black has only one good move, which is d6, so defending the knight and attacking the pawn, and after captures, black will capture this bishop, and this position has so much threats. And first threat you can already see by the arrows, that black is threatening the bishop check and gaining the white queen. And the first, let's see some of the options of the white. So first option is, if the white take the pawn, queen cross g7, then the game will be lost already by white because of this nice tactics, bishop on the e5. So now queen has only one square to go, and after this black will simply take the queen, and after bishop recaptures, you can see the b2 square, it has been weakened, and now black is simply a rook up. So there is a 1q trap. White queen can go for the other pawn, which is now b7 pawn, like this. So queen goes to e4, and after the bishop e6, now it can take another pawn, which is on b7. But after the knight d7, you can see already the black pieces are so much developed, and white is only playing with the queen. It's just like a beginner's opening, and although black is 2 pawn down, I would not prefer to be white here. I have seen one game in database which goes like this. So white played e3 to protecting that c4 pawn, which was attacked by the bishop, and now black simply castle, and finally white develop a piece, which is knight f3. That's too little too late, because black has a nice tactics over here. So black plays knight c5, and the last horrible mistake by the white was this one, now queen to b5. And I wonder if you can spot a very, very nice tactics by black. Okay, so black plays over here, rook to b8, and now queen has been attacked, and you can see queen has two squares. Queen can go to c6, but if it goes to c6, then rook to b6, and queen does not belong to this world. So in this game, white played queen a4, the only square, and now 2 is horror, he has to face this move. And there are so many threats over here. Okay, let me show you. Let's say if the bishop take this knight, then at least black can give a check and pick up this queen. So that is not possible. If the queen, king moves up, for example like this, then it will lose this bishop. And the third possibility, which actually happened in the game, which opponent plays like this, queen goes to d1, but after this move he resigned because of this lovely fork. So see, there are so many good threats available in this line. Okay, there's another good trap available in knight f3 line, in this line. It's a decent looking move. Black continues over here castle, and after there are also two possibilities. So one is knight c3, logical move, carrying on with the developing. Now black has this move, knight c6, gaining time on the queen. Queen goes back to base, and now black has this move, bishop to c5. So it's eyeing up on that juicy f2 square, and although it's offering the trade of the queen, it's not a good trade for the white. So in this game, white defended first of all that threat, but after the queen exchange, you can see it cannot take the by the king because of the fork. So white has to capture with the knight, and now amazing knight to b4, and you can see the c2 square, it's not easy to defend, because if the rook comes to b1, then the bishop f5 will be nasty. So it's virtually almost a winning position for the black. So let's say after this position, instead of knight c3, if white is feeling not comfortable, he can play this move h3, and I can't tell you, this is a disaster move, and I have beat few guys with this move, and the move is this one, knight c6. Now you can already see that if the queen goes back, then again we have the familiar trap, which is knight to f7 and bishop goes to g3, lost the queen. So in this game, white played this move, queen e4, but it's just helping the black to develop the pieces. So first black played this move, rook e8, gaining a time on the queen. So queen goes back to c2, and now again gaining a time on the queen. So attack with the knight. So queen finally stable on the c3. But now I wonder if you can spot the nice tactics by the black. It's very, very wonderful. And the move is this move, knight check, knight to d3, and it's very amazing move. And the problem is, if the king comes to the d file, then it only has to face discover check, or it's a very disaster position. And if it comes to, especially comes to the, let's say d2 square, for example here, at least white has this move. So in this game, white decided to capture that knight, and meeting the bishop check, please note that any pieces comes in between can be made by simply queen takes queen, and white cannot capture back because the e pawn is pin, this pawn is pin. So white forcefully has to go here, but to his horror, he will realize that it has been forked by other way. So this way, so now it's a family fork, and it's a lost position. So that kind of traps can be occurred if your opponent is not familiar with these positions. Okay, so that is about queen d4 and queen d5 lines. Well, if that much is threatening, white can simply give up the pawn. So many people plays like this, e6, just give back the material and try to stabilize this position. And first time when I see this, I can't believe there are even the traps available in this line. And just see this. So bishop check, and if knight c3, then takes the knight, and the pawn will be crippled. So very obvious response is bishop to d2, and now comes the amazing move, queen f3. And now you can see black is not threatening to take the b2 pawn, but it's already threatening the mate. And even at the moves such as e cross f7 and king cross f7, the threats remain same. So the only decent way to block the checkmate, first of all, is the knight f3, and now black will simply snap up that pawn. And now after takes, yes, the material has been regained, but see the weakness, the white has the isolated pawns, and that kind of positional advantages you are getting in the Budapest line. Okay, so those are some of the short traps, I can say, in the knight g4 line. Now let's see some of the cute traps in knight e4 line, which is known as Fajar's Gambit. If my pronunciation is wrong, please excuse me. So knight e4, and as I know somewhat of the theory, the bishop check, and black is going for the fast development. So in the first trap, probably white knows about this. So he played a3, stopping that bishop check, and now black has this move, d6, and after captures, bishop takes d6, and white plays knight f3, and such a natural looking move can be proved disaster if you are not careful in Budapest. And can you spot it? Yeah, it's a knight take f7. So again, that technique. So king takes, and now bishop, and the queen does not belong to this world. So that is cute trap which often occurs in Budapest. So please watch out for those kind of traps. And in second trap occurs when white plays this move, queen c2. So like playing the queen such early stages cannot be good, and black can exploit this. So first move is this move, bishop check, and here in this game white played knight d2, which is somewhat okay move, it's not that bad, and black plays this move d6, and after e cross d, Black's carrying out with the first development. So bishop f5. So now idea is knight to g3 and gaining time on the queen and gaining the rook on the in the corner. So white was desperate to go out from the diagonal. So he gives a check. So black played knight c6, and now another bad move. a3. As I said, that if you are lagging behind in development, it's not very good idea to play passive moves like a3 or h3. And you will see in a moment why. So black plays this move, knight c5, and here still I thought that white should play queen to d8 and accept that his position is not good. But here white becomes so much ambitious and he played this move, pawn takes, which is look bit natural because it's counter attacking the queen. But I wonder if you can spot the nice tactics by black. Okay, the move played is queen to e7, and now you can see that if the queen goes back to d8, d1, then there will be a nice move is made by knight check. So white has only one square. White queen has only one square, which is to go over here. But as you can suggest, as you can see, it's so much exposed, and it's most likely it's gone case. So black easily exploit this. So he first of all played at six. And after the queen this move, bishop goes over here, and now the queen is checkmated. And white played one last try, but just black simply take that, and now the queen is gone. So that is some of the nice traps available in knight e4 line. So far we have seen where white does not play that much accurately. And now we are going to see some of the main lines of the Budapest. Well, white still play very accurately, but still fall into some of the our good traps. So the first line we are going to see is in knight g4 and bishop f4. So this is one of the main line of the Budapest. Bishop f4, hanging on to this pawn with the development. So here, I thought I should show you the main Budapest trap. Although some of you know about it, it's not a proper video if I am not showing you that trap. So let me first show you that trap, so which is a famous Budapest trap, which inspired many people to play this gambit, and it goes like this. So knight c6, knight f3 defending on the pawn, and now bishop checks. If the knight comes, then pawn will be crippled. So in this game, white played knight d2, black plays queen e7. And after the moves of a3, move like a3, black played this move, knight takes e4. And if white is take this bishop, then we have a nice mother's mate. So there is a nice Budapest trap. And even though, let's say white knows about this trap, and if he plays moves such as knight cross e5, knight cross e5, and now e3, then still you have a nice game. So your bishop has to capture. It's a forced move. After queen takes, you can play d6, and even if you can see that if the trap doesn't work, you have still nice stable game, and there's even a theory on this position, so you can check it out online. Okay, so that is one of the cute trap of Budapest. Okay, in this game we already see knight c6, so here opponent play bishop b4 check. And white played knight d2. We can understand this because if the knight c3, then the pawn will be crippled. So knight d2, and now comes this again, this move d6. And after grabbing this pawn, black has this amazing move, queen f6. And again, you can see it's not only attacking the b2 pawn and bishop, but it's also threatening the f2 mate by the queen. So there are two ways to defend this. The first good way is logical way is e3, but then it can simply made by this continuation. So takes, and now black is threatening to take this knight and then the rook in the corner. So white has to play this move, knight f3, and then after takes, taking this pawn, again white has a positional weaknesses all around the board, right? So that's an e3 line. And now at this position, in one of the game, white played this move, this horrible looking move, g3. And here the trap works so effectively. So black played this move, g5. and you can already see it's a very very disastrous position for white, so it cannot move that bishop. So white tried this move, but then again black just take out the knight and the threat remained the same. And after the move such as a3, if black wants, he can gain a piece by taking the knight and then take the bishop, but the black player was ambitious, so he goes for this line. So he took this bishop, and after white recaptured this bishop, he played this move, f cross g. And please note, if white played f3, then g2 will be curtains for the white. It's all over. So in the game, white played this move, desperate looking move, knight e4, gaining time on queen. But after check, queen goes over here, check, and few moves of the black like this, black is simply a rook up in the game. Games continues like this, knight f3, and after queen check, white to his horror find out that it does not have any good moves, so he has to block this check, and then it gain the queen, and it's going to be easy from here for the black. So that is few good traps in the bishop f4 line. And let me discuss a very very shock trap for your opponent, which many people are not aware, and that occurs after here at this position. White played a sensible and solid looking move, which is knight f3. Okay, idea is very simple. So after knight c6, black is playing e3. It's not not want to be ambitious. He want to try to concentrate on the development, and he's just returning the pawn back. Okay, fine, no problem. So black will take here, and normal moves like bishop e2, try to castle on the king side. And here there are many moves, but there's one of the recent development theory on this line is g6, which is fianchettoing the bishop on the g7. And here white played knight c3, which is a logical move, and after here black took first that knight and then placed the bishop to g7. Okay, there are books and videos available on this line which tells you like this. So the theory goes like this. So queen goes to d2, then b3, and bishop goes to g3, and then g2 and castle on the king side, and that is the whole theory of this line. But the problem with this theory is there is a nice trap waiting to be hit, and I'll show you what I mean. So in this game, white plays logical looking move, queen d2, and black plays d6, and after b3, black plays this move. And if the white is not aware of this trap, he might play this move, bishop e2, and here comes our trap. So queen to g4, and when I look at this position, I thought, okay, it's not a big deal, there are many ways to defend this. But more I look at it, more I found it it's not at all easy for white to defend that. For example, if the white likes to castle over here, then he has to face this move, so he will be exchanged down, so that is not possible. If white has to play this move, which first sight it looks forking two pieces, but then after this move, still black is very good. So that is not possible. And finally, we have this move, g3, which first sight looks okay, but there's an amazing move here, which is queen to f6. So now the threat is knight to f3 check and getting that knight on c3. And natural looking moves like bishop to b2 can be made like this, knight f3 check, forking king and a queen. So white has to accept, and now again the threatening the rook, and you don't believe, but white cannot castle over here, because if it's castle, then he has to face this move, because the only way to move make the checkmate is to move queen to d5, and then at least if white black wishes, he can capture the rook after taking the queen. So even g3 is not possible. And final move which has been played in the game, which at first sight looks very strange, which is this move, bishop f1. Try to undevelop the piece, but it has a venom, because now it's indeed threatening f4. And here comes the amazing, which is, I wonder if you can spot it. Just try it. Okay, black can play this move. Bishop to h3. And now, first sight it looks unbelievable, but more you look at it, more you will find it's a very, very precise move, I can say. And now the thing is, well, there are many things. First of all, if g cross h3, then the worst of all, then knight fork, so that is not possible. If rook g1, then again knight f3, and now if the captures, then black king can capture the rook, and now the bishop is pinned. So that is again disaster. So the third option is f4, which first sight looks okay, but after the queen check, still it's disaster for white, and you will be able to see in a minute. So here there are few moves. So first we look at g3, that it can be made by this move, knight fork, and after the king moves anywhere, simply white will take the knight, take the queen, and after white recapture the queen, you can take the bishop, and now you can see it's not a pleasant position for the white. So that's not possible. G3. What about else? Queen f2 can be made by this move, and now you can see it's a disaster zone for the white. And finally, king can run away, which is king to d1. But even though this position is not good, it's true that black's two pieces are hanging, but see the elegance of the position. So first of all, black give a check, so first piece comes out from the danger, so king goes over here, and now the second piece comes out, and see the white position. It's artificial castling kind of position of the white, where the knight is still pinned and black has a pleasant position, like I can say. The simple idea is the king side castle and the throwing the queen side pawn if it's wishes. So that kind of threats are available. And after the bishop f1, the move actually played by the white side, which he was very high rated player, so that's why he knows everything, and he played this move, knight e4, and the black played queen e7. And the good thing about it is still the white cannot capture the bishop, because there's a fork there at knight on f3 square. So white played bishop b2, and now black simply castle. And now look at the king side pieces, they are very hard to develop. And finally white played this move, castling on the queen side, but now it's indeed threatening our bishop, so we have to move a bishop. The bishop goes back to f5, and now the simple plan is a5, a4, and black has simply good position. So that was the overall package of the Budapest opening traps. I tried to cover as many as traps I could. Only thing I can recommend for this opening is try in your own game, and you never know, maybe any opponent can be your victim, and you can use as a shock weapon even in the tournaments. Well, thank you for watching my video, and please feel free to comment on my video, and I'll meet you soon. Bye.